Hey Kryptonites, this is Shane from Crypto Coin Growth, and this is part 3 of our Coinbase Tutorial Series. Now, I mentioned in the earlier videos that part 3 was going to involve sending and receiving within Coinbase, but I feel it'd be more appropriate for the flow of this series to make part 3 about buying and selling coin within Coinbase. And speaking of parts 1 and 2, if you haven't already seen those, feel free to follow the link above my head to get caught up to speed. So once you're logged into your Coinbase account, and assuming you already have your payment method set up, you'll be ready to start buying and selling. So to buy and sell, you go to this tab here, and you'll see buy is automatically displayed, and then sell is off to the right here. Bitcoin is also automatically selected by default, but you can also select these other coins. For the purposes of demonstration, I'm just going to work with Bitcoin, but the buying and selling process within Coinbase is the same for these other two coins. So Bitcoin is selected here, and I have my default payment method listed. If you want to choose another payment method, feel free to click this drop down here and select the payment method you want to use. Under amount, you'll see that there are two boxes here, one for USD and one for BTC. I recommend using the USD box just because it's something that we work with every day and it's easier to work with and understand what you're buying and selling. You fill out the amount you want to buy. In this case, say you want to buy $10 worth. And it'll show to the right here how much Bitcoin you will receive in your wallet once the order goes through. And this button here says buy Bitcoin. Make sure that the number to the right in the button here is the amount that you want to buy. So you click buy Bitcoin. And to the right here, you'll see confirm your transaction. So from this point, you could either continue with the transaction and place the buy order, or you can cancel out of the transaction. Something to do before you make either of those decisions is to look to the left here and make sure that the details listed here are correct. So this is the payment method I want to use. It'll show when it will be made available in my Coinbase account. Because I'm buying coin, it'll be deposited to my Coinbase Bitcoin wallet, and this is when it's estimated to be deposited. You look at the fees, subtotal, and the overall amount of the order. Once all of that checks out, then you can confirm the buy, or if you want to back out of the order, you can click cancel transaction. So let's look at selling. With selling, it automatically displays BTC wallet. And you can see the drop down here for the two other coins, but I'm just going to work with Bitcoin in this case. And very similar to the buying option, you'll have a drop down for where you want to deposit the overall amount that you sell. So if you have set up multiple depositing payment methods, then they'll show up in this drop down. Then under amount, very similar to buy and sell, you have USD to the left and BTC to the right. So say I wanted to sell $20 worth of United States dollars. A difference to keep in mind here is that you want to look at the amount here that is to the right in this button. I put 20 here, but it shows $18.51 because it accounts for fees within the order. So depending on your payment method and how much you actually want to sell, this is a factor to keep in mind. So if I make this, say, $21 instead, you'll see that the amount increases with it. Once you want to go through with the sell order, you click sell Bitcoin. And just like with the buy order, you confirm the details to the left here to make sure that everything checks out. Withdraw from BTC wallet, that's what I want. And the deposit in the selected account here that you're going to deposit to, is estimated to be made available at this date. Now, if you've seen part 2, you'll know about the different wait times for different payment methods. In this case, I've selected a bank account and it'll be made available in about a week from now. So this is an estimate, but this is a good ballpark estimate to go by. Then you look at the fees that'll be charged, subtotal, and the overall total payout. And like I said, this total payout is the amount that will be deposited into the account that you've selected. From this point, you can either confirm the sell or cancel the transaction if you want to. With either method, buying and selling, it's very simple within Coinbase. You just click some buttons and you play the waiting game. So that concludes part 3 of our Coinbase tutorial series. I've shown you how to buy and sell Bitcoin within Coinbase, and the same process works across those other two coins as well. Part four will involve sending and receiving coin within your Coinbase wallets. Hey, thanks for watching. Like and share this video. Subscribe to our channel for more content like this. Push the bell icon to get notifications about our latest videos and follow the links in the description below. I'm Shane from Crypto Coin Growth. See you next time.